In this video, we're going to look at how to create an IntelliJ IDEA project from the code in a GitHub repository. The first thing we need to do is to clone the repository to our local machine. Let's use this GitHub project as an example. We're in GitHub, looking at a repository on my profile. This is the IntelliJ samples repository. We want to clone this code, and there are several ways to do this. We can use HTTPS or SSH, amongst other options. Let's use HTTPS as it can be the simplest option. When we click the clipboard icon, the URL will be copied to the clipboard. If we start IntelliJ IDEA and we don't have any projects open, we'll see a welcome screen. The welcome screen varies from version to version. This is the welcome screen in IntelliJ IDEA 2020.3. Regardless of your version, you'll have an option to get a project from version control. Clicking on this gives us the Get from Version Control dialog. We can paste the repository URL into the URL input box. We can change the directory the project is created in if we want to, but for this demo, I'm going to keep this at the suggested location. When we press Enter or click Clone, IntelliJ IDEA will clone the GitHub repository to the directory we selected. IntelliJ IDEA will also pick up common build tools like Gradle or Maven and automatically download the required dependencies and build the project. When we open up the project window, we'll also see that IntelliJ IDEA has detected the modules in the project and correctly sets up the test, main, and resources folders in a Maven project like this one. There's more than one way to clone a GitHub project from inside IntelliJ IDEA. If we already have a project like this one open, we can choose to get a new project from GitHub using the VCS menu and selecting Get from Version Control. We'll then see the same dialog we saw earlier, asking us for the URL and project directory. One of the most useful tools when we're working with a Git project is the Git tool window. This gives us visibility over the version control status of our project. One way to open the Git tool window is to hover over the quick access button in the bottom left of the IntelliJ IDEA window and select Git. This will open the Git log window. Alternatively, we can use Command and 9 or Alt and 9 on Windows and Linux to open the Git tool window. The window shows us all the commits for the project. We can also see a list of local branches, which in our case is just the main branch, since we just cloned this repository. And we can see the remote branches too. If you find a visual representation of the commit history useful, this window can help you to understand the status of commits, branches, and remotes for your project. When we're working with open source projects on GitHub, it's common to have more than one remote associated with a repository. If we go back to the IntelliJ samples project that we cloned from GitHub, we can see that this is actually a fork of another repository. This upstream repository is in the JetBrains organization and is likely to be updated by multiple people at a different rate to my fork. Ideally, we want visibility of the upstream repository as well as our own fork in order to get a better idea of what changes have gone in and to update our own fork with these changes. Let's copy the URL of this upstream repo and go back to IntelliJ IDEA. I'm going to use Search Everywhere, which I call up by pressing Shift twice. If we type remotes here, we can see one of the search results is the Manage Remotes option from Git. Selecting this brings up the Git Remotes dialog. Here we can see the remote that we originally cloned this project from. This is my fork of the IntelliJ samples repository. We want to add a new repository for the upstream repo, the original JetBrains repo. When we press the plus button, we can paste in the path to the JetBrains repository, and we can give it a name. There are a number of different conventions that you could use to decide on the name for your remote. For example, you could call it upstream. I like to use the organization or profile name so it's unambiguous. We can also use this dialog to make changes to our existing remotes. I want to rename the origin remote to Trisha G, because that makes it clearer to me where this remote is pointing. Now, when we look at the Git tool window, it's clearer which remote the remote branches belong to. Like most features in IntelliJ IDEA, there's more than one way to open the Manage Remotes dialog. We can also right-click on the remote node in the branches tree of the Git log and select Manage Remotes. The last thing we're going to look at is why and how to invoke a Git fetch. We just added a new remote to this project, but it's not showing in the Git tool window. This also means, of course, that none of its branches or commits are visible either. This is because we haven't fetched the status of the new remote to our local project. We can call fetch from the VCS menu under Git Fetch. When we've pressed this, IntelliJ IDEA will go and get all the relevant details from all the Git remotes we have for the project, and the Git log window will be updated with all these details. Now we can see a new remote in the log window, and we can see all this remote's branches. We will also be able to see the remote's branches in the commit list. This gives us a clear idea of which commits are on which branches, and if any branches need updating. Another way of performing a Git fetch is to click on the Fetch All Remotes button on the Branches Tree toolbar in the Git log window. Now we have a fully configured IntelliJ IDEA project from a GitHub repository, with all the relevant remotes added, and a Git log window that shows the current status of the remote repositories. Now we're ready to start making changes to this project and to commit, push, and create pull requests. Thanks for watching.